Feel free to move about the cars. Just be careful when you go between the cars. There's a drop plate there between the cars where you can pinch your fingers or your hands or your feet. Just be careful moving between them. As far as looking out through the vestibule doors, be extremely cautious when you do that, and I would highly recommend not leaning out, because sometimes there can be tree limbs, rock cuts or something like that, and you don't want to get hit in the head with that. Other than that, there's the baggage car, which has an open door on both sides. That's really great for viewing. You can see wildlife and the river, and there's a couple chairs back there. Also, there's a kind of like a small little museum back there with pictures of the line and engines and trains and whatnot. But the good museum, or if you want to have more information on the line, is in the gift shop / station, where there's lots of pictures and maps and things and descriptions. Also, I would recommend each person got on their seat there, they got a description of the line, the history, the type of cars used, the history of the cars, history of the locomotives, history of the line, and so it's real helpful in understanding. You can use that by looking out the window here. Sometimes you'll see a milepost. You can compare the milepost with that on the brochure. When we get towards the end, when we get around the turnaround point, what we would like for you to do is trade sides, so that the side that had the riverside will have the mountainside or the hillside on the way back, and those that had the less scenic side on the hillside or the mountainside can go into the riverside. We have coffee and snacks. Coffee is free. Snacks are $1 a piece. And then not only the dining car, which is the car forward, but also the bud car, which is the car behind us. And there's also a soda pop for sale. She's helping me out. I'm not the normal guy. Anything else you want to add?
You're doing good.
Yeah, usually I'm loud and boisterous, and anyway, not so much today. We'll stop on the bridge of the confluence of the Wallowa and the Grand Ronde River, and let everybody will be able to get a good view of the two rivers there coming together. The Grand Ronde, of course, comes out of the Blues, meets up with the Wallowa at that great big bridge right there, and then flows into the Snake River from there. If anybody has any questions, Feel free to ask any of the volunteer hosts or me. I'm a retired railroader, so I might be able to help out with some of the more technical questions about railroading. So anyway, have a good trip. And like I say, if you have any questions, what I need to add, no smoking, but I think everybody takes that for granted anymore. No smoking is almost universal everywhere you go. So anyway, no questions?
How about the guest book at the end?
There's a guest book at the end that the host will hand out. I'll just take you with me to the next car. you can prompt me.
I'm happy to go with you.
All righty. Well, thank you very much. All righty. Thank you for riding. Once again, we appreciate your patronage, and we'll see you along the line.
He's like, read what it says. That's weird.
Thank you. that the check on it?